Welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to check out some more Bon Jovi. And we are also going to touch a little bit on what is being talked about recently about his vocals. So I hope you guys are all ready for this because we are really getting into it today. The songs we are talking about today are Always Run to You and Only Lonely. I do want to tell you guys that I know Only Lonely. I couldn't help myself. When I was looking up songs to do today off of the album 7800 Fahrenheit, I saw Only Lonely and I was like, I couldn't help myself. I love this song too much and that I knew that I could like really lip sync to. Besides Steve Clark's birthday, you know what I mean. And also, I've been really wanting to give my opinions and everything about the songs. It's a win-win for my, in my books. That's what we're doing today. You know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications of when I upload, and let's get straight into some Bon Jovi. So let's talk about what being said about John Bon Jovi vocals. Okay, so. Let me try not to get like overly into this, right? Because I can get very passionate and it can seem like, okay, why are you getting so mad? But I'm not, you guys, let me just first state that. It's not anger, it's just Italian speech and New York tones, okay? It's nowhere, it's passion. It's not mad, angry, or anything like that, okay? That's all. Let me make that clear first. So, I saw a video recently, just like yesterday, about people talking about John Bon Jovi's vocals, how they're going downhill. And then they talked about how Raleigh, North Carolina concert, he sung Wanted Dead or Alive and it didn't sound too good. I listened to the recording and yeah, it wasn't that great. Also, we don't know if he could have been sick. We don't know the logistics about it. I also saw other videos. People are like, John Bon Jovi's vocals. Is it over? What is this? Like, Bon Jovi, vocals, downhill, like these dramatic headlines about Bon Jovi and John's vocals deteriorating or whatever you want to call it. Cracks me up because you guys, people are acting like this just happened overnight. Like all of a sudden, John woke up and his voice box just like decided to not work. Like last tour, he was singing all the notes, and this tour, none of the notes. You know what I mean? That's what to me is like what's going on right now. I keep it honest on my channel. I want to remind anybody who's watching, if you're new here and you don't know that, I keep it 100. I keep it honest. I tell you my honest opinions and thoughts, and I respect your opinions and thoughts. I just don't want you guys to. The only thing I don't allow is like hate in my comment section. So if you don't like something I say, there is a respectful way to say it. So remember that if I'm about to say something you don't like, or if you don't agree with, there's a way to respond, and it's called peaceful. First, let me tell you something. I'm a big Bon Jovi fan. I love Bon Jovi. John Bon Jovi, he just turned 60 and he still looks good, like with the silver. I need to stop. Anyway, his vocals, guys, let me tell you a secret. Some of you guys may know this already, but John's vocals has been going downhill since the 80s. You know who was doing a lot of those high notes? Richie Sambora over there on the guitar. That man is incredible. John's vocals, when they were making Slippery, You Make Love a Bad Name. I love that song. That song has some really high notes in it. Very, very high notes for John. And John hit those every night. Maybe not every night, but you know, constantly hitting those notes, trying to hit those notes, straining the vocals. vocals is really gonna damage your vocals, your vocal cords, your vocal muscles, and really gonna mess up your vocal cords. Again, how many times can I say that word? So eventually, you know, the one really catching him when he couldn't do those chords was Richie Sambora. And that isn't saying John can't sing. Damn, John was going constantly strong so long. He's an incredible guy. This guy's a legend. There's a reason he's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But go and watch that Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and you will see that his vocals didn't just magically stop all of a sudden. There was a bee that just like booped my window. Didn't just all of a sudden go downhill. They've been. And through the years, he's had to work harder to sing certain songs and so on and so forth. You get the picture. I need to move along so I can get to these songs. But it didn't happen overnight, guys. That's the big thing, okay? But we don't go to see singers like that for their vocals. If you're going for their vocals, why are you there? You're supposed to be there for the band, for who they are. Rock and roll gods. They're in their 60s. They don't have the same vocal strength as they did when they were 20 or 30. That's not how that works. I mean, I want to see them, for the fact that they are Bon Jovi, the band that sold X amount of records, the band that sang millions and millions of people, millions of faces, and they rocked them all, you know? That's what I want to see. And because it's John Bon Jovi, you know? Just like Guns N' Roses. Guns N' Roses, that's Axl Rose up there. That's Slash looking hot on that guitar. Excuse me. And Duff McKagan on that bass guitar. And yes, Axl sounds like Mickey Mouse sometimes. But damn, that is still Guns N' Roses up there. Like, some of the greatest music to ever live is from them. Just like Bon Jovi, some of the greatest music to ever come out of music entertainment, period, is from Bon Jovi. Now I'm getting heated. It's because I'm getting overly excited and passionate about music. Okay? You get where I'm saying? Good. Discussion's going to be closed now. So, you know what? Let's just listen to that music now. Always Run to You. Let's go. always run to you. As always, I'm gonna tell you what I think this song is about. So I literally pulled up here and I get the feeling that it is about knowing that there is, that this guy loves this girl so much that he can always run to her. That a one night stand isn't what he wants. It takes a serious relationship. That's what he wants. That no matter what happens, all roads lead to her. Tough scene, whatever, it's always her. Whether they're separated, together, no matter what, he can always run to her. That's what I think the song is about. Let me know your opinions, leave it in the comment section down below. Now, let's talk about the song itself. The intro, wow, that was incredible. The drums, Tico on the drums was just incredible. He just rocked it hard. Oh, incredible. The vocals were on point. So beautiful and so perfect, especially for what the song was about. It just fits so well. It was so catchy, the chorus especially. And then, man, Richie, of course, you have to mention his guitar work. So heavy. It also had, just the song itself had element of pop and then metal in it. The guitar solo was just out of this world, especially the end solo, the ride out was just a chef's kiss. It was everything. This song was incredible. I loved it. That was my opinion. Let's move on to one of my favorite Bon Jovi songs, Only Lonely.
Another long and sleepless night. You need some.
So great. So great. Only lonely. Always, I'm gonna tell you what I think this is about. And looking at the lyrics, knowing how the song goes, I think it's about not wanting to lose that person you love, though the relationship, things are getting in the way, things are rocky in that relationship, you're hurting each other. Things would be better off if you two were apart, but just like the lyric says, I got this time bomb ticking in my head. This time I think she's gonna blow. How can I say get away when I just can't let go? I mean, none of us want to be lonely, but sometimes it's for the better when you're hurting another person or they're hurting you. So that's what I think this song is talking about, just the hardships we go through in relationships. Let me know your guys' opinions in the comment section down below. Now let's talk about this song itself. I have a lot of favorite Bon Jovi songs, but honestly, I always go back to this song. I don't know why. It's just so great. I mean, yes, you have the likes of You Give Love a Bad Name, Dead or Alive, which is incredible, and Living on a Prayer, all incredible songs, but I just Only Lonely. There's something about the way it is set up and is performed. The solo portion is just so epic. Richie did just such an incredible job there. And the whole song's just priceless. It's relatable, it's relevant, it's timeless. The high notes in this song are just incredible. Are just incredible. The drums at different places, especially like the part where it breaks down into the time bombs ticking in my head. That part was, oh, I love that. The do-do-do-do-do. That definitely how a drum sounds. But everything just was set up so perfectly and expressed in a way how you feel. Like you're about to lose everything, lose control, and that's the feeling of that song. That song makes you lose control when you're jamming out to it, when you're vibing out to it. You gain that same loss of control, and I really like that kind of. I don't know, I doubt that was on purpose, but I get that link when you're telling stories. I mean, they could have went into a ballad form of it, but instead they made it into a powerhouse of a song. I love the vocals. I think John's vocals on this song were so raw, they were so strong, they were so powerful, they were incredible. This song. And if you're like me and you love John Bon Jovi himself, go watch the music video if you haven't yet, because you can see him shirtless and he looks totally hot. Oh yes, me being a fangirl of just a bunch of rock dudes that are in their 60s now. I'm so in the wrong era. Anyway, those are my thoughts on everything. What were your guys' Well, Always Run to You was great. They both were incredible. Bon Jovi's just incredible. Man, those are my opinions. Let me know your guys' opinions in the comment section down below. The rest of the week, you guys, tomorrow I'll be talking about grief when dealing with illness. Saturday, you guys have Skid Row. We're starting their first album. And then Sunday, we got some Sweet Sunday. So that is your schedule for this week. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys are staying safe and well. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.